This is a sunnah too. This is a sunnah too. This is a sunnah too.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Welcome, dear viewers, to another episode of our program. This is a Sunnah 2. Inshallah, just as in the previous episodes, we'll be covering another beautiful Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam related to his blessed character, his mannerism. And inshallah, with this intention, we are going to listen that we will act upon and implement the blessed prophetic teachings in our life to gain betterment in the dunya and the akhirah as well. So inshallah, the topic of today's episode is showing affection towards children. Now children, they make up a large number of people living in our communities, in our societies. Nearly every household has children, alhamdulillah. And children are a big blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But is it the responsibility of a parent or a guardian to just feed the child? To just clothe the child? Is that the only thing that is binding upon them? Or is there something beyond this as well? And inshallah, you learn that a guardian and parent has to do much more than this. And one of those things that we must do with our children is show affection towards them. If you have a father, for example, who comes home always in an angry state, an angry mood, he's come from work and he's shouting, he's scolding his children, just ordering them around, do you think they will develop love for that father, or will they just be in constant fear of him? Conversely, if there's a father who comes home, he realizes that he's had a stressful day, but at the same time, it's not right to take it out on the children, the spouse. He goes towards his children and he says, I missed you. He begins to play with his children. He begins to make them laugh and fill them with joy. Imagine the effect that that will have on those kinds of children. SubhanAllah, they're constantly receiving love, this warmth, this protection. And this is what we need to do in our lives as well with our children. We need to make our children our best friends. Not distance them. Not make them our enemies. And one way we will achieve that is by showing affection towards them. And let us listen to a hadith right from the beginning. Sayyiduna Jabir radiallahu ta'ala and states that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ لَمْ يُوَقِّرْ كَبِيرَنَا وَلَمْ يَرْحَمْ صَغِيرَنَا. That the one who does not respect our elders and the one who does not show mercy and affection towards our youngsters is not from us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said what? That those people who don't respect the elders and who don't show affection towards children, the youngsters, he is not from us. The Prophet alaihi wasallam has categorically said it. He's not from us. Why? Because the way of the Prophet ﷺ was different. The Prophet ﷺ throughout his life showed affection, great affection towards children. The children loved him. They wanted to be in his company. He was merciful towards them. Let us hear another hadith and then an account from the life of the Prophet ﷺ. Sayyiduna Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala narrates that the Prophet ﷺ said, O Anas, respect the elders and have mercy, show affection towards the youngsters. You will attain my company in paradise. So what's the reward for showing affection towards children, for respecting our elders? That person who does so will attain the blessed company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah, in paradise. Subhanallah. And this was a great sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he would show affection towards children. And we have an account where it states that when the Prophet alayhi salam would return from a journey, and the kids would be in anticipation, they would meet him, they would welcome him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would stay with them. He would place some children in front of him on the ride, some behind him as passengers. And as for those children who were not fortunate enough to be on the ride with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the front or at the back, in regards to them, the Prophet alayhi wa sallam would instruct the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in, that, O Sahaba, you place them in front of you or behind you. And what would happen is these kids at times would, subhanallah, show great pride in the fact that they were fortunate and blessed to sit on the same ride as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They would say to one another, the Prophet alayhi salam made me sit in front of him, or the Prophet alayhi salam made me sit behind him. Allahu Akbar Kabira. And some children, they would also show pride in the fact that the Prophet alayhi salam instructed the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in to place them on their rides. They would say to others, the Prophet alayhi salam instructed, the Prophet alayhi salam told the Sahaba to place me on the same ride as him, as that companion. Allahu Akbar. Imagine that scene, subhanallah. This was the shafaqah, this was the affection of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We know that newborn children were brought to the court of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it was requested in the court of the Prophet alayhi wa sallam to make dua of barakah for that child, and at times to name that child as well. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would take that child in his lap, his blessed lap. And whilst in the lap of the Prophet alayhi wa sallam, what would happen sometimes is the child would urinate. Can you imagine? The child would urinate whilst in the lap of the best of creation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the crowd, in the audience, people who were gathered there, some would express anger, some would express displeasure. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not prevent the child from urinating. And the child was left alone until it had answered the call of nature, it had urinated. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make dua for that child. The Prophet alayhi salam would bless that child with a name. And after giving the name, they would even have glad tidings, good news from the court of the Prophet alayhi salam on behalf of the Prophet alayhi salam conveyed to the family members, so that the family members don't think, what has our child done? Our child, ma'adallah, urinated. And the Prophet alayhi salam was harmed and pained by this. No, the Prophet alayhi salam would send good messages to them, so they don't even think like this, subhanallah. And then when the child would be taken back to his family, the Prophet alayhi salam would wash his clothes. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Is there an example like this? Subhanallah. The Prophet alayhi salam was so affectionate towards children. The Prophet alayhi salam would kiss children affectionately. The likes of Imam Hassan bin Ali radiallahu ta'ala and his grandson, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam's grandson, Imam Hassan, the Prophet alayhi salam would kiss him. Aqra Tamimi was once sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, I have 10 children. He saw this. He saw the Prophet alayhi salam kissing Imam Hassan bin Ali. And Aqra Tamimi said, I have 10 children, but I do not kiss them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in reply, the one who does not show mercy will not be shown mercy. Meaning you should kiss your children. You should show affection towards your children. Allah has blessed you with children. Don't be stone-hearted. Don't be emotionless. SubhanAllah, show love towards your children. And those children who are shown that love right from the off, they're shown that warmth, SubhanAllah, they go on to achieve great success in their life. As opposed to those who mentally tortured, are spoken ill of, are scolded, are looked down upon, that child will lack confidence. That child will not want to go on and do anything. That child will lose determination, willpower, and all these other qualities. So we must encourage our children. And one way is to show them love right from the beginning. Once a villager came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, you kiss children, but we don't. Just like the previous individual. Prophet Alayhi Salaam said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes mercy from your heart, what can I do? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has removed mercy from your heart, what can I do? Meaning this is a sign of mercy being in your heart, that you embrace your children, you kiss your children, you show affection towards your children. Just like the Prophet Alayhi Salaam would show affection towards his grandsons. And as you heard, Imam Hassan bin Ali radiallahu anhumah. Sayyidina Jabir bin Samura radiallahu anhu states that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was leading salah. And he states regarding himself, Sayyidina Jabir bin Samura, that I was offering salah behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When the salah had concluded, the Prophet alayhi wasallam went back to his blessed home. And I accompanied him. I went with him. On the way, there were some children. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam stroked the cheek of all of those children affectionately, subhanallah. And he did so to me as well. Sayyidina Jabir bin Samura radiallahu anhu said this. And he states, subhanallah, he describes that particular situation. He says, the coolness and the fragrance that I felt, that I sensed when the Prophet alayhi wasallam touched my cheek, subhanallah, it was as if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had taken his hand, his blessed hand, out of a box of fragrance that an attar, a perfume seller has. Subhanallah. That's how much fragrance I sensed and felt. And the coolness of that touch, subhanallah. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would pass by children, he would convey salam to them. He would give salam to them. Subhanallah. This was the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we have to ask ourselves, what do we do in this regard? Are we also affectionate to our children? Or are we stone-hearted? And you just heard, if you don't show mercy, you won't be shown mercy. And youngsters, children, we must show affection. We must be merciful towards them. Sayyidina Abdullah bin Ja'far bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu states that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would return from a journey, the children of the Ahlul Bayt, the prophetic household, would be brought to his noble court. And once the Prophet alayhi salam returned from a journey, and I was the first child to be brought to the court of the Prophet alayhi salam, Sayyidina Abdullah bin Ja'far bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu is stating regarding himself. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam placed me before him, in front of him, on the right. Then, the two sons of Sayyidatuna Fatima radiallahu anha were brought, Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhumah. And he sallallahu alayhi wasallam placed them behind him on the right. In this manner, all three of us were on the same ride as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And in this state, we entered Al-Madinatul Munawwara. Subhanallah. Again, look at the affection of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Normally when a person comes back from travel, a long journey, he's tired. And these things are not on his mind. And he probably just says, hello, how are you, to a child or anyone he meets. He's not really in the mood for a lengthy conversation. He's tired, he needs to eat, he needs to freshen up, etc. But look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go out of his way to please children, to make children happy. And we need to do the same as well. Because this act, this amal, as well as being a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single act that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, subhanallah, that is pleasing to the Creator Allah azza wa jal. The uncle of Sayyidina Abu Rafi' bin Amr Ghifari states, I will go to the gardens, the orchards of the Ansar, and I would throw stones at the trees. And what happened was they took me to the court of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet alayhi wa sallam asked me, oh young child, why are you throwing stones at the trees? I said, to eat and consume dates. The date palm trees. So the dates would fall down and I would consume them, I would eat them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not throw stones. As for the dates that are already on the ground, eat them, consume them. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam affectionately stroked my head and then made a dua for me that, oh Allah, satiate him. Subhanallah, fill his stomach. So this is how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would show affection. In that situation, another person may have expressed great anger that, how many times did you do this? You've been throwing stones, you silly boy, why are you being so childish? Even though he's a child, when are you going to grow up? No, the Prophet ﷺ just asked. And when he answered that, I want to eat the dates, the Prophet ﷺ said, don't throw stones, but as for the dates that are on the floor, pick them up, eat them. Allahu Akbar. Look at the polite manner, the affectionate manner in which the Prophet ﷺ spoke to this child. And then he stroked his head. He stroked his head, made dua for him. Ya Allah, satiate him. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu states, whenever any crops would become ready, any harvest would become ready, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was gifted with that harvest, that fruit, etc. It was brought to the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And upon this, the Prophet alayhi wasallam would make a dua that, oh Allah, grant blessings in our Medina, in our fruits, in our mud and sa'. These are measurements. Grant blessings in all of these. After this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would gift fruits to the youngest person there. He would initiate by giving fruits to the youngest person there. Whoever was the youngest, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would present fruits to him, would give fruits to him. This would obviously please his heart. This would make that person happy. Look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his affection towards children. Out of all those children that were there, he would give it to the youngest. And this is what we should do as well, inshallah. Let us end with an account, inshallah. Sayyiduna Abu Uthman Nahdi alayhi rahmatullahi al-qabi narrates that on one occasion, Sayyiduna Umar radiallahu anh made a person from a particular tribe a leader, a hakim. When he came to the court of Sayyiduna Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anh to accept this role, he saw that Sayyiduna Umar radiallahu anh was present, and so was a young child of his. And Sayyiduna Umar was showing affection towards his child, was kissing his child. And when he saw this, that person who came to accept the role of a hakim, a leader, he was amazed. He said that, you are kissing your child, this child. I've never done that with my own children. Upon listening to this, Sayyiduna Umar radiallahu anh expressed great displeasure. He disliked the fact that this person has just told us he doesn't do this with his own children. He doesn't show affection towards them. And he said, فَأَنْتَ بِالنَّاسِ أَقَلُّ رَحْمَةً. From the people, you are the one who possesses the least amount of mercy for others. هَاتِ أَهْدَنَا لَا تَعْمَلْ لِي عَمَلًا أَبَدًا. Give back this role to us. Meaning, we don't want to offer this role to you anymore. After you have told us that you don't do that with your own children, you don't show them affection, you don't embrace them, you don't kiss them, give back our role. And you will not be given such a role ever again. Allahu Akbar Kabira. This is Sayyiduna Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anh, who learned from the court of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed affection towards children. Sayyiduna Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anh learned from the Prophet alayhi wa sallam, and when he was told that there's a person who is going to accept such a big responsibility, yet he doesn't show affection towards his own children, how is he capable of doing such a big responsibility or having such a big responsibility? He said, give it back. This role's not for you. You won't get this role ever again. Allah, we are to show mercy towards our children. They're a gift from Allah. Show them so much love. They don't have to look elsewhere for that love. Make them your best friend. And inshallah, you will see them prosper in both worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to adopt this blessed sunnah of showing affection towards our children. Ameen. Bijahin Nabi al-Ameen. Sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam.
This is a sunnah too. This is a sunnah too. This is a sunnah too.